McLaren's landing some of these leg kicks. You know, it can, and that's going to slow down that shot that Striegl so effectively uses in that double leg takedown. He likes to blitz in on people. If he can wear down that lead leg of Striegl's, he's going to have a hard time shooting. He lands another one right there.
Threw in a right and a left there, McLaren, but Striegl just moves his head out of range. So even if he does get caught, a lot of the power is removed.
The fifth leg kick that he's landed, Steve. That's gonna wear down Striegl's explosive ability.
There was some redness on the outside of Striegl's right leg. Testament to, there's another one.
It's kind of southpaw versus southpaw here, which is a unique situation in a lot of cases. You don't get to spar a lot of times with a straight southpaw. As Striegl spins him around into a double leg takedown, McLaren does a good job of popping back up, though.
Puts everything into these double leg attempts, doesn't he, Striegl?
There's a headlock attempt that Reese kind of shook off, and now it has the back of Striegl. Striegel's going to try to roll, possibly.
Just shaking their arm down, taking a moment's breath. Minute and a half gone in the second round. We're at the Mall of Asia Arena. This is ONE Championship, Spirit of Champions.
See another leg, and he's just, Striegl's just taking it. He's eating it on that right leg there. There's another one.
See the redness there on the on Striegl's thigh.
And Striegl just smiles at him and takes it. This is a huge step up in competition for Reece McLaren. He knows this is Hopper's opportunity. He took the fight on short notice, and he's trying to make the most of it possible. But I like how he's switching back and forth in stances. Now he's fighting out of orthodox again.
That last kick actually made Striegl's right leg buckle a little bit. It's starting to tell. Striegl's landed the heaviest, and he followed up with the technical ground kick.
He completely stunned McLaren, and McLaren was shocked as he dropped to the canvas.
I thought it was over for a second there, but
I think Striegl thought so too as he kind of stopped and paused. He thought he had a walk-off knockout, and he just kind of stopped, and if he would have jumped in a little bit sooner. He's trying to threaten the possible Kimura here. You can see how he's locked in that arms. Now he's got the Kimura grip. He's a bad position for McLaren.
The crowd recognize it too. He's scooting around to try it. Yeah, he's managed it, but the technical ground kick comes in and he gets up as quickly as he can. And everybody appreciates that effort.
McLaren jumps right back in with the combination as Striegl looks up at the clock.
The writing was on the wall for a moment there for Reece McLaren. And full credit to him for getting back up onto his feet. And Striegl found that a little bit tough. He's breathing hard now. You can't really blame him, but he'll get points for his aggression and for what he managed to achieve. Meanwhile, that right leg continues to get a pummeling. Again, it buckled, and again.
Striegl looks exhausted. He's just taking these shots on the leg. Look at the welts that are building up on the side of Striegl's leg.
I talked about the intensity at various times that Mark Striegl showed, particularly at the beginning of both rounds when he goes for the double leg takedown. But now that he's a little bit gassed and that leg must be struggling a little bit, that intensity seems to have gone.
If McLaren can kind of turn it on a little bit, he's just being very tentative, but he's landing significant shots. He might be a little bit timid to kind of shoot in because he got dropped the last time he tried it.
Can't wait to get to Rich Franklin's opinion on how this should be scored at this point, but I fancy Reece McLaren can take a little bit of confidence away from the end of this round, despite perhaps being on the receiving end overall. Either way, Striegl's right leg will be very happy to take a break in 20 seconds time.
See, you would think that, but actually if he sits down on that chair, it's the legs are gonna kind of get cold a little bit, and you don't want to do that, because when you get up off that chair, it hurts.
He's struggling with that leg. It's a constant target for McLaren, and you can see the way Mark puts his right leg down that it's hurting him a bit.
If he would fake, there he goes to the head. I was just gonna say, if he fakes to the leg and goes to the head,
Well, Reece McLaren came in a tad after the bell there and got a bit of a stare from Striegl.
There he is, Striegl shooting in for that double leg takedown that he does so beautifully. But here's that stop. Boom with the elbow. Catches McLaren right onto the chin. Goes in for the technical ground kick, but McLaren guts it out. Here's kind of a stand-up Kimura, which looks kind of weird. But then there's a technical ground kick to follow it up. And he lets him up. Let's go drop to Rich Franklin, see how he has it.
But I tell you what, this is where I'm glad I'm actually just a TV judge and not one of the real judges. Look, I think Striegel's still a bit more aggressive, but that's low on the totem pole here. He's winning on the actual takedowns and a little bit on the ground control, but McLaren's running away with the striking superiority, and I actually have him outscoring Striegl on damage due to the leg kicks at this point in time. Even though Striegl had that knockdown, it was kind of a flash knockdown, and he followed up with the kick. I don't think it was enough damage. So right now, if this fight was stopped, I would give the fight to McLaren.
That's fascinating, because there's more red on the Striegl side, but the more significant work done is at the top of the chart. The categories that we give more credence to is at the top of the graphic you just saw. So the judges, as Rich said, have a tough time. And there's still 5 minutes to go. What a second round that was.
The final 5 minutes all come down to see who can pull the trigger and really push that pace. Who is the better conditioned athlete in the final round of this fight? Because this is really what it comes down to. How much pace can you put on your opponent and see if he can keep up with you? Ooh, nice little left hand there landed by McLaren as he sprawls out from the takedown. Oh, he jumps into a guillotine. That's deep. Look at him with the tongue out.
He's got his tongue out.
Striegl just pushes him off.
There's a second attempt at it. No, he wriggles free. Still in trouble, the knee to the head at the same time. Taking all kinds of abuse, the Filipino. What a performance this is from the late stand-in, Reece McLaren.
He took this fight on short notice, and he has proven that he belongs here. What a lot of people don't know is that Reece McLaren is half Filipino. His father is actually Filipino, and he's never met him. So this is his chance to get in touch with that national pride and really bring it to Manila.
I didn't know that. That's good information. If only the fans knew, they might well be supporting him a little bit more than they are now, because at the moment they are silent in sympathy for Mark Striegl.
There is something pushing this kid forward to take on a superstar like Mark Striegl and to be dominating this last stanza in that round. Here comes the ground and pound.
At the 5 minute mark, Striegl was ahead and there really wasn't much dispute. At the 10 minute mark, Rich Franklin has Reece McLaren in front. And now he's got 3 minutes to consolidate, and Striegl is taking punches to the head. He's defending fairly well, but a lot of those punches are getting through. His head cannons off the canvas.
Uh-oh, he slid the arm under the neck. This is a bad position for Striegl.
We did not expect this, and nor did the fans here at cage side. A warning about punches to the back of the head. So he has to make sure that those punches come underneath.
He's got to aim for the ear, but he has landed some brutal shots. He's got 2.5 minutes to work.
Striegl's in real trouble, but McLaren has to be careful about those back of the head shots. Now it's easier for him to hit the face. Striegel's covering up, but he's throwing nothing back, and he's in trouble, Mark Striegl.
Striegl is exhausted at this point. You can see the big gasping breaths that he's trying to do. He has no strength left to push away and try to move. He is just getting pummeled here.
Under the armpit, 7-8 consecutive punches, flush in the face. Mark Striegl doing nothing to fight back. Olivier Costa is looking very carefully. He's asking Mark Striegl, what do you want to do? Do you want to fight some more? We may be near the end, 1:50 left in this final round.
Striegl's showing a big heart here. I think he's trying to pull the energy from this Manila crowd. Uh-oh, he's trying to get under the neck, but you can see that Striegl, oh, he just lost the defense of that hand. Now he's in trouble.
Under the chin. Watch for the top. And it comes.
What a finish.
Reece McLaren beats Mark Striegl in the Philippines. Improves his record to 8-3, pays his respect to his opponent, and it's fair to say, That is a surprise. A late stand-in, a late replacement. Look, he stunned himself. Oh. What a performance from this 24-year-old. Let's get Rich Franklin's thoughts on a fight that did a 180 midway through the second round.
I'll tell you what, more stuff happened in that last 3 minutes of the fight than the first 10 minutes. I was sitting here with my scorecard, just like marking away with things. I couldn't hardly keep my eyes down up. Yeah, it's just crazy.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Olivier Coste calls a halt to this battle. At 3 minutes, 33 seconds of round number three, for your winner, by submission, via rear naked choke, Reece Lightning McLaren!
Fight!
All right, slowed down a little bit. Looked like a sprinter about to get out of his blocks for a while there. Oh!
Gafurov says he's got some stuff to show this fight that we have not seen yet before. And the skill set he's demonstrated so far, I'm looking forward to this one right here. Nice attempt. Easily sneaks in, takes the back. Drags him down, ends up in side control. Reese has got high-level Brazilian jiu-jitsu, and you can just see as he's very, very sneaky about as he attempts to slide into mount there.
We think of 24-year-olds as being young men, but he's got that edge in terms of experience and probably cage generalship, McLaren. 5 years on Gafurov.
See, that's where McLaren needs to be. He needs to stay tight to the ground game of Gafurov. He's got to be careful of those legs. Sambo's got some crazy leg locks.
It's been a while since we saw a leg lock submission in the ONE Championship cage.
McLaren really needs to keep that distance close, stay very tight to Gafurov, not allow him to get comfortable and start throwing some of those really interesting dynamic spinning strikes that he's known for.
Thinking back to the days of Masakatsu Imanari, leg locking Kevin Belingon in Singapore a few years ago. It'd be nice to see something exceptional like that again.
Sambo's got a lot of really wicked leg locks. They come at you from all sorts of different angles, so you really have to be careful, especially when you're just like a strict BJJ guy who's not used to dealing with a lot of those leg locks that come from Sambo. But Imanari is the king. Oh, big takedown! Dumped it onto his head. That was like a trip and a double leg at the same time.
Tremendous strength.
Just planted him on the back of the head. You gotta wonder if he's a little bit rocked by that. Just the daze that comes when you get put on the back of your head like that. Your head just bounces up. McLaren's trying to get into mount. He's trying, but it looked like Gafurov was gonna climb up the cage with his feet.
Just propelled himself upwards, didn't he? Oh, technical ground kick landed.
McLaren's got just a constantly moving sort of just his scrambles that he creates when he's in the ground. He's just really impressive the way that he moves.
McLaren's got to hop around at the moment, and all it will require is Gafurov to sweep that leg away, and there'll be another takedown. He's looking for it there. And I see Rich Franklin scribbling in the takedown column.
Good takedown defense, but Reese is very comfortable off his back here. You can see he kind of uses that half guard to stand back up once he has the underhook and a nice takedown of his own.
Oh, vicious, vicious forearms. Gafurov will have to watch that. That can end any fighter's hopes. And cut you up.
See, Steve, here is the interesting thing about this fight. We're about 90 seconds away from Gafurov entering uncharted territory. He's never been out of the first round.
It's a very, very rare occasion for him, that's for sure.
You know, and that's going to do something to you, whether you admit it or not. When you go into places you haven't been, there's that little bit in the back of your mind that's, I've never been here before. How will my body respond?
McLaren showing the quality that he's got.
Sorry, let me correct myself. He has been out of the round, out of the first round, twice. So this is 8 first rounds.
It's very rare, whichever way you look at it, and it's still going to cause him a bit of bother mentally that he's found someone who's difficult enough to not just be dispensed with at will.
But more so than that, Reese is controlling him in every single ground exchange. Look at this, how he's controlling in side position. Now he's got a crucifix position as Gafarov's trying to roll out of it. He's trying to get out. Now he's wall, the elbows are coming. He's got 19 seconds.
Fascinated to see how Rich sees this first round, because Reese McLaren is creating a few waves here.
Oh, he's going for a guillotine. Possibly it's tight. It
looks as if he's got it in tight, but the end of the round is going to come soon.
Gafurov looks okay. He's got the arm in. That's all
there
right.
There we are.
What a first round for Reese McLaren.
We knew it was going to be high-level stuff, Mitch, and it's delivered on that promise.
Oh, yeah. Reese McLaren showing a very, very tough ground game. There's that double leg. I don't know if you can call that a double leg. It's kind of a single leg scoop slam as he plants him on the back of his head. That's all head. That's not back. And then there's that Gafurov as he clinches the leg and just kind of gets tight. Good flexibility shown by Reese McLaren here as his knee's pretty much into his face. And then Gafurov swept the leg. And here's that arm in guillotine by McLaren to end the first round. But if we jump to Rich Franklin, how do you have it so far, Rich?
Well, at this point in time, McLaren's going away with this fight. He's clearly ahead of the game on the takedowns, and he was controlling the ground. He did a really good job controlling the ground. I actually, on the first takedown, the second takedown that he had, scored him a little bit of damage. The way that inverted Gafurov, you could just see that it kind of knocked the wind out of him and took it out of him. But he also continued to mount some damage with the kicks as well. So as of right now, McLaren's ahead on the scorecards.
Ready?
Fight. 5 minutes down, 10 to go. Remember, we score the fight in its entirety. That is not one round in the books for McLaren. He's just ahead at this point. This is the best way to score a mixed martial arts fight, isn't it, Mitch?
Rather than
the 10-point must system.
You know, it eliminates so many problems that we have with conventional mixed martial arts scoring. And it really just judges the fight on a whole, which is so important because all fights are on a whole. You know, you can't win a fight just by adding the takedown at the end of a round. It's got to go on the whole thing and what happens. There's another one threatening the leg locks. Beautiful as he spins around and ends up in side control.
Twists himself out of it to his advantage. Tremendous stuff from the Australian.
You can definitely see Gafurov trying to climb up the cage and really just kind of create new positions. But that just goes to show you just how tight McLaren is to each one of these positions. He can't get him off him, and how strong Gafurov is. Man, every single fight this kid, you can't count Reece McLaren out, regardless of how highly touted his opponent is coming into this fight. Reece McLaren is really putting on a show here.
The grounding.
These elbows to the thigh, that's gonna slow Gafurov down in the later rounds.
Jumping the gun tremendously here, but if McLaren can win this, you feel he has the pedigree to perhaps be Bibiana Fernandez's next challenger. Gafurov, presumably you wanna let him fight a couple more times first if he can win this one. Win or lose, Gafurov can come again, that's for sure, at only 19 years old.
Clipped a couple of the whiskers there of Reece McLaren with that spinning back kick.
Those punches not looking quite as crisp as we've seen previously.
Yeah, you can see the way that Gafurov is trying to escape a lot of these grounded positions where he's trying to use power to throw Reese off, and that's going to suck a lot more energy out of you than using just a little bit of technique when you try to create space. But Reese is not giving him that space.
Gafurov clearly knows that he's in the fight of his life so far. He's never met an opponent this resourceful, this strong. Tremendous takedown.
Beautiful double leg takedown as he turned the corner and just dragged this fight back down. But Gafurov's got a guillotine.
It's under the chin, I should say. It looks tight.
But you see how high McLaren is? It's hard to get that leverage with your arm when it's when your opponent's that high up on you.
So pulling it tight enough is the problem?
Yeah, you got to get more leverage. You got to be able to get your hips into it and really crank down on that neck. And so you can see Reece just easily popping out of it. See how he also keeps that shoulder, that left shoulder on Gafurov's face? That really controls a lot of the places that Gafurov can go.
McLaren is so quick just to spin around and move around.
Yeah, Steve, he scrambles so well, constantly moving. See, look at that.
Yeah.
He goes for the double leg, doesn't get it, immediately shoots in and spins to the back.
Very nimble footwork, very nimble change of body weight, brother balance.
Come grab.
There's that power again. He's stuck in half. He's stuck in side control. Gafurov is, and he's trying to use that leg to crank out. Now McLaren's got him in north-south, but he goes back to side control. You know, McLaren likes to finish from the mounted position, so expect him to try to slide that knee across and work from the mount again, because Gafurov's not really defending quite well there.
Less than a minute to go in the second round. Rich Franklin had McLaren quite a way ahead after the first 5 minutes.
See, he just see Gafurov trying to use that power to throw him off. And he stands back up.
Right and left hand from Gafurov. And again, McLaren looks for the legs.
Good sprawl by Gafurov. That's what he needs to do more of. Trying to go with the arm throw, but McLaren drags him, just sucks him back down to the ground.
He's been a lot more commanding than I expected.
See, he's trying to crucifix that arm. See how he's putting his knee on Gafurov's left arm
right there?
And now it's in between. Now he can just punch.
Good.
But I think he's going to get out of this round again. I think we're going to see a third round, Steve.
So what that crucifix does is it just opens up the face for punishment?
Yeah. He can't do nothing. He's just getting punched in the face.
Mitch, we're not going to go to replays. I want to see what Rich Franklin thinks of this scoring. I really want to see.
I'll tell you, Reece has completely surprised me. Gafurov is a strong kid. He's 19, but he's a strong kid. And Reece is just working him in all aspects. He's scrambling. He's very aggressive. Coming in, he's landed takedown after takedown after takedown. I'll tell you, the one thing that Gafurov did score in that round was it was a near finish. He had a tight guillotine in. I scored him for the near finish. But it's not enough to counterbalance the amount of control that McLaren has on the ground and all the takedowns that he's had. So at this point, 10 minutes into the fight, McLaren has just increased his lead and he's winning the fight.
Just to reemphasize, it's not necessarily the amount of red versus the amount of blue to see who's ahead. You've got to look to see where the red is. Is it at the top of the chart? Near finish is very important, but when you take everything into context,
back.
Rich is seeing McLaren ahead so far. And that seems pretty fair to you as well, Mitch.
Yeah, he's doing, I mean, Reece McLaren is just showing a very, very high grappling game here tonight against a very tough opponent. You can see that Gafurov is a little bit flat-footed. He doesn't have that quite that aggression that he started the fight with or that he's had in the past. That was a big, heavy shot.
And a right hand from McLaren. This is a tremendous match, probably the best match pair of the evening. It's the one that stood out for me when I saw the card for the first time. Good left hand from McLaren.
Yeah, you can see that McLaren respects the striking game of Gafurov so much that he wants nothing to do with it. And the first chance he gets, he is shooting in for that takedown attempt. You can see Gafurov's corner feverishly trying to wake him up and get him back into this contest. Oh, that could have been a low blow, but Gafurov thinks he's okay. He's fine.
What about the prospect of
back of the head just thumping shot?
The illegal blow is between the ears at the back of the head. Of course, a lot of that time it's accidental. There's not a lot of intention, but that's what the referee looks for in terms of an illegal blow to the head.
You got to have some contact to the ear whenever you throw a shot back there.
See, just McLaren's like Velcro, you know? He just gets on you. It's so hard to shake him off. Ooh, nice. There's that spinning back attack from Gafurov again.
Wouldn't you just love to see the winner of this one in the cage with Bibiano Fernandez?
That looked dangerous. I think McLaren turned his head at the last moment. He might have got clipped on a collarbone there by a nice knee by Gafurov.
Oh, overhand right from Gafurov, and he's swinging in air. McLaren is getting out of the way, although he was clipped there with two or three punches. And McLaren had to sink to his knees.
Wow, Gafurov is coming alive in this third round.
Wow. Is he going to be able to turn this around, Mitch?
He's got 3 minutes.
And swing.
It can't go to his decision, Steve. I think he's too far ahead in the scorecards, as Rich Franklin was saying. So Gafurov needs to finish in the final 2 minutes and 40 seconds of this fight.
Rich, is that the case? Does he need to finish this before time?
If he doesn't finish this fight, he has to do a lot of damage. Just given the amount of time that Reese has controlled this fight, he would have to do a lot of damage to finish this. His best bet at this point in time is to stand this fight back up, because he started landing some big shots with the overhand right while he was on his feet, and he's just wasting time on the clock here, in my opinion.
Nice little sweep, how he used that heel, and then he kind of ended up in possible heel hook position, but it was a nice sweep by McLaren to buy a little bit of time, like Rich Franklin said.
A shade over 2 minutes left. We haven't seen any of the smiling or sticking of the tongue out from McLaren in this one. He's far too busy dealing with this phenomenal 19-year-old, but he does have the edge on him for now.
A takedown is not gonna do it. Rich Franklin was right. Gafurov has gotta let go and let all of his head weapons go. Oh, nice little catch. Almost lost the mouthpiece too.
Just clipped him with it, didn't he, as Gafurov was backing off. Not a punishing blow, but one that catches the judges' eyes. What can Gafurov do? 90 seconds left. He has to pull something out of the bag.
You can see his mouth hanging open. Gafurov is exhausted, and so is McLaren. Both these fighters leaving it all in the cage tonight. That's what he's doing, though. He's spinning around the right way, but he gets dragged to the ground again for another takedown by Reece McLaren. Man, he's got 1 minute. That could have been it for Gafurov. But he's using those feet to try to climb back up. He's trying to get back up to his feet, not accepting defeat.
His arms in there. The final 60 seconds.
Uh-oh, there's a possible Kimura there. He keeps trying to step over that leg. Now he's landing knees from the side control position. 41 seconds, we're getting real close to the wire.
Kimura attempts aside. You fancy that McLaren might just want to nullify his opponent for the last half minute, knowing that he's probably ahead. If he can prevent Gafurov from doing anything significant, the game is surely his. 20 seconds.
Such good control by Reece McLaren. He is putting on a grappling clinic.
Even looks for the rear naked choke in the final 10.
This is it. This could be it. Oh, he
shakes him off on the left hand. Gafurov comes back with two or three punches, but that's your lot. Olivier Cost steps in there. Gafurov takes the mouth shield out of his mouth and slings it across the cage in frustration. Conversely, McLaren lifts his right hand into the air because he knows that the judges are very likely to see him as the winner in three rounds of very, very entertaining mixed martial arts.
What a tremendous contest. Rich, what do you think?
First of all, let me just say that this night of fights, I would like to say it's the best fight of the night, but every fight has looked this way tonight.
That's right.
Working up the categories, Reese was a little bit more aggressive the entire fight. He won the takedown category. He scored more takedowns, was able to control the ground from side mount, just more superior positions, landing and actually inflicting damage from those. But also on the feet, he edged it out in my mind. Gafurov, the only category he really won was the near finish, but it just wasn't enough to give him the decision. My opinion, this should be a unanimous decision for McLaren.
You've heard Rich's view on the subject, and I fancy the judges will see it the same way. Sometimes they see things we don't, sitting at various points around the cage. perspectives are all important.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges, see it for your winner. Via unanimous decision, from the red corner, Reece McLaren!
This contest brought to you by City of Dreams Manila, a world-class destination. McLaren in Southport starts. How long before we see Reece Lightning look to take the contest to the ground? Bunrad would rather stand and train. And there's a whipping high right roundhouse kick from the Thai early on.
I'm surprised Bunrad hasn't really adjusted his stance to maybe lower the stance to defend the takedown a little bit better. But he's okay to fight to play his game. And we can see that, you know, Reece McLaren is comfortable on his feet. He's moving in and out, floating around very nicely.
Though both men stand at 170 centimeters, the obvious reach in both the legs and the arms goes the way of Bunrad. And using that reach well at the moment, probing with the lead hand. Follow through with the rear leg roundhouse kicks. McLaren not willing to give up center cage. Evades that high left roundhouse.
McLaren went for a knee tap takedown for his first one. An unusual takedown that we typically don't see coming from McLaren.
Checks the inside thigh kick to Reece McLaren from Christmas Island, Australia. Gets out of the way, leans back like Fat Joe to avoid the high right roundhouse. Jab from Reece.
I like how Bunrad is immediately starting to take out that lead leg of McLaren. It's going to slow his shot down and kind of keep him as a stationary target. Reece a little bit. He smiled at him to let sure know he got him a little bit.
McLaren drifting left, meaning he's drifting into the power right side of Anupam Bunrad. Could spell disaster for the Aussie. Jab to right hand, counter right there from Bunrad. Doubles up with it, hits the jaw. Inside knee kick and Lightning came over the top of the right hand. There's a right from Bunrad. Now Reece McLaren looks for a takedown.
Slick duck under right there, but good job by Bunrad to get the underhook and defend the takedown well. But McLaren was able to get the hands underneath the hips and complete a double leg takedown. Nice elevation though from Bunrad. This is what Bunrad wanted to show us. He wanted to show us these improved BJJ skills he's been working on out there in Belgium.
Reece McLaren's 6-week training camp says he feels reinvigorated. Lands on using his grappling. He's inside the guard at the moment. One butterfly hook off the right leg from Anupam Bunrad. Now the full close guard from the tie. Elbows from Lightning. Postures up here as McLaren tries to drop the right hand. What has Bunrad got off his back? Can he push him back here? Look for feet on hips.
Standing,
can't get
standing.
It. Reece looking to pass aside.
Reece is controlling the legs very well, not enabling Bunrad to put those feet on the hips where he could possibly push away. See how Reece slides out of the way? Bunrad got that left foot on the hip, but Reece is able to step over it and just slides right out of it.
Shows.
Double butterflies here from Bunrad. All the BJJ experience over 200 competitions coming into the fore. For Reece McLaren, the Aussie, a corking knee to the buttocks area. Still the butterfly guard here from Bunrad. Now feet on hips from the tie, and there's the pushback. Explodes to his feet. Good plyometrics, and we're back to a striking contest. Shoots in for a double leg. Does McLaren. Big takedown. Shakalaka. Beautifully done from the Australian.
Once he's able to get those hands under the hips, there's not a whole lot you can do to stop it. He executes a beautiful double leg takedown. Now he's trying to pass over into side control. See how he's pushing down on that left leg there, trying to slide his right leg out, just like that. He clears the knee from the legs of Bunrad and easily passes into side control.
Nice. Reece McLaren putting on a Brazilian jiu-jitsu clinic at the moment. Full mount! He won't stay there for long, however.
Arm triangle right here. All he's got to do is jump over to the other side to complete it. But Bunrad gets out of it almost into half guard. Bunrad survived these
these 30 seconds, Michael.
It's been good defense from the Thai side, but here comes Reece trying to set for another choke. The Aussie wants to find a finish.
Oh, that's a slick and a counter.
Can he find it now? Reece McLaren, can he find the finish?
Oh, there's seconds left. Is he
gone? Lightning Reece McLaren back in the winner's circle
with moments to go in the first round. The adjustments that Lightning McLaren was making, that is what high-level, world-class Brazilian jiu-jitsu is all just those positions. He had the anaconda. He didn't like it. He transitioned out of it, floated over, ended up in the mount to finish the Darce. Beautifully done by Reece McLaren.
That is what Reece Lightning does. A BJJ clinic.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Draft Andres, property president of City of Dreams. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 52 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of Darce choke, Reece McLaren!
Choke! Gianni Subba of Malaysia. Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chawson with you. Early fakes and feints here from Subba in the white. Can one of these two men score the big kibosh, the go-daddy knockout of the night? You figure it may come from Subba. He's the knockout master. On the ground, Reece McLaren should, on paper, have the advantage. Inside leg kick from Subba. McLaren, southpaw starts. Left-handed. Thought about a high kick, did the Aussie. Subba fakes again. Both men have speed in the hands, speed in the legs. Looks for a takedown as McLaren. Subba stuffs it.
Ooh, good confidence builder from Subba. Stops that initial takedown. And he's got McLaren up against the cage.
No fence.
Clearing him around against the cage here, Mitch.
Controls the clinch, has the body lock. Look at that, nice and tight from both guys. Look at him struggle.
Both reversal upon reversal. Both men pressing their backs against the cage.
Fence.
The pendulum swinging one way, then the other. This is what you call jousting.
Look for McLaren to change levels. But Subba's got that underhook on that one side, on that right side, so it's gonna be hard for McLaren to drop down. Going to the inside knee tap.
Let's go, guys, what?
Trying to change.
Elbow there from Gianni Subba, off the right arm. McLaren would love to get Subba down, love to put Subba on his back. So many options for Lightning Reece from there. Subba would like to break off, have some distance to work his striking, those knockout blows off his hands. McLaren keeps him pressed back against the cage, Mitch.
This first exchange is going to tell us a lot. Is McLaren going to be able to win the battle of attrition, drop down, change levels, get the takedown, or is Subba going to ignite this crowd, survive this position and get away? And he does just that.
Left hook at the breakup from Subba. And there's the right hand, the power salvo. Jab two from McLaren. Now McLaren in orthodox stance. Body shot from Subba, trying to change angles, trying to disguise his punches.
Faked it with the other, trying to get an ankle pick there. Subba fell for it a bit. Let's see if he uses that later somehow in the round.
McLaren with the jab. Switches back to southpaw. Constantly switching stance here is the Australian. Subba swings a little wilder off the backhand. There's a ripping high right round.
roundhouse kick. Loses his footing there to McLaren.
We saw the striking on display when McLaren went five rounds with the champion in a higher weight division, Bibiano Fernandez, one of the world's best. We saw McLaren break Bibiano's nose, completely deform his face.
Subba trying to give McLaren a taste of the power in his gloves. There's a right hand from the Malaysian. Tracking roundhouse kick, but Subba saw it coming, managed to scoop it away. Drops the right hand to the bread basket.
That's just Subba being a little bit tentative on the strikes. Not really, hasn't really opened up yet. He rushes there and connects with the right hand.
Good straight line punches down the center corridor from Subba. And McLaren will have no more of it. Driving takedown, look for a choke attempt. Ooh. And now the full mount from the Aussie.
Just jumps right into full mount.
Oh, downward elbows, top of the head. McLaren getting higher on the mount. This is McLaren's territory.
Subba wants to push off the legs, start moving those hips out, not trying to sit up like that. Now McLaren's got him up against the cage.
McLaren with the elbows. His corner's telling him to stay heavy on top of Subba. This is where McLaren wanted to be. The elbows again from the Aussie.
See how Reese laces around the left hand. Hits that left hand of Subba so he can't defend. He can't start pushing off of it. Good defense, good offensive strategy by McLaren. Now he's trying to frame up on it. Now he's going to try to jump over into half guard.
Goes to side control.
Right to side control. Now he's attacking the head.
Dominance on the ground here from Lightning Reece McLaren.
He's trying to walk over north-south. There's a choke here. He's got a head and arm.
Time may be against McLaren. It is indeed. Into the first round. A real round of two contrasting styles. On the feet, it was Subba. On the ground, it was all McLaren.
There's a beautiful elbow on the exit of that clinch. But right when Subba was trying to open up with those strikes, boom, Reese caught one on the chin there. But here, look at this. This is why I was saying Subba was afraid to open up, because that's what's coming. That beautiful slide under takedown. Reece McLaren's on top and was able to control the match from that point on. But now we're getting into the second round here. Now they've had a good feeling out process of each other. You know, Reece McLaren knows that Subba can touch him on the chin, and Subba knows that McLaren's gonna get him down. So his game plan's a little bit tighter at this point.
It is all part of one championship, the largest martial arts organization in the world. And wherever you're watching in 136 countries, we hope you're enjoying all the superb action from inside the mighty Axiata Arena in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Second round of three. McLaren bounds out of his corner. He switched between southpaw and orthodox in the opening round. And he opens up a southpaw here in the second.
Subba's got to be careful rushing in like that. That's what Joyce McLaren's going to do. That takedown.
Lovely counter right hand there from Subba.
Ate the body kick, but to counter with a right hand of his own.
Oh, beautiful. Almost taekwondo. Jumping roundhouse kick there from Subba. Both men do a little posturing. Opposing, the crowd enjoys it. Two highly skilled martial arts athletes at the peak of their powers, Mitch.
Just big whiff on that kick. Both of them calling their shots, pointing to the upper deck.
Jab from Subba.
Now we're starting to see the swagger start to ooze out of McLaren. This is what we saw in the Bibiano fight. If he wasn't doing so much posturing, if he wasn't doing so much showboating, I think he could have caught, he might be holding the bantamweight belt right now. I don't want to see him get caught up too much in this and have too much fun in there. I want to see him start to put it on in Subba, because Subba ain't falling for it.
It's a little something called the Aussie larrikin nature. And it's coming out again here in Reece McLaren.
American?
American nature. A rascal, a larrikin. That's what Reece McLaren is. But it's also a way for McLaren to try and get inside of Subba's head. Subba comes forward with straight line punches. Goes for the inside leg. McLaren hasn't switched to orthodox. He's maintained the southpaw stance. goes for a takedown. Uppercut, hook combination from McLaren. Nice left hand, didn't turn the knuckles in.
Aleksi is going after the lower leg. He's going after that calf and shin of McLaren, which is going to slow down that shot. Aleksi can keep doing it. Throw those punches, throw that low kick.
Overhand right there from McLaren. Subba jab, scores out nicely. Good takedown defense from the Malaysian. Eats a left hand to the jaw. Looks for the hamstring there. Does McLaren.
Goes for a knee tap there.
High knee! Misses. Trying for the meet and greet. The Muay Thai technique from Reece McLaren. Subba locks him up. McLaren breaks out. Subba comes forward. A little sloppy on execution of those two straight punches. Look at the feet here on both these men, the way they stand. You'll see McLaren's back foot is very, very solid out, much more so than Gianni Subba's.
He's having a hard time moving back. He takes about two steps forward, and that's where Subba's connected him.
McLaren hopes for a takedown. Gets a takedown. Subba on his back. McLaren's got him melted again.
Falls
now passes to side control. Here's the choke.
Arm triangle.
Here's
deep.
The choke.
Done, Michael. Dove into the double leg. Let's take a look at that one more time. That was so pretty. He dove into the double leg, slides over, gets the arm triangle, and just puts the squeeze on. There's the Lee family.
Angela Lee, Bruno Pucci, Christian Lee. Angela will be taking on Mai Yamaguchi in a rematch in May in Singapore. But here's what went down in this incredible finish.
Look at that double leg, got the knee tap, fell into the top position, got the mount right into the arm triangle. And that's how big, how strong of a squeeze that McLaren's got. Subba, no place to go. Taps Reece McLaren into a world title shot.
The most dangerous creatures in the world are in Australia. And you just saw one of them named Reece McLaren. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 12 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of arm triangle, Reece McLaren!
Southpaw stance on Reece McLaren in the green and navy. Red trunks on Wada. Fakes here from Wada. Circles into that lead hand of McLaren. There's the high lift roundhouse kick. Very underrated striking on Reece McLaren. Wada, as Mitch said earlier, extremely crafty, a cerebral martial artist, can come at you from angles you didn't know existed.
Yeah, I was talking to Wada's coach, Royo Chonan, and he says Wada's biggest strength is his mind, how quickly he can adapt to opponents, find their weaknesses, and then exploit them.
Vincent Perry, the coach of Reece McLaren, telling us that Lightning is coming supremely prepared for this one. They are making a run at flyweight gold. They need a win over Wada tonight. It would be a big scalp to claim. They tango, clinched up. Takedown there from McLaren, posted up and got back to his feet, did Wada.
Wada bounced right back up to his feet. Even though McLaren's got the body lock, Wada was still able to get back up to his feet very fast.
Chance for the knees here to be thrown. Wada with an uppercut to the body, takes a groin strike. Accidental there from Reece McLaren. Will be recovery time here for Tatsumitsu Wada.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has called for injury time. Our athlete has up to 5 minutes.
5 minutes to recovery time for Tatsumitsu Wada. Here he is, it's on the inside. Just looks like the shin may have caught the cup of Wada. I believe the knee actually caught him in the bread basket. If Wada is unable to continue here, an official decision will be given. So
full 5 minutes allowed for Tatsumitsu Wada to recover from the accidental groin strike. The knee thrown in close by Reece McLaren.
Wada's got a lot of experience inside the cage with 30 professional mixed martial arts battles, but no matter how many times you've been in there, you never get used to getting hit in that ever so delicate area.
Potter is ready to go on here.
Fighter, ready? Ready? Time. Chok!
Olivier Kos gets us back underway. Up high on the balls of his feet, coming forward, Reece McLaren always pushing the action. Dropped down for a low single, didn't get that, fires a knee from the clinch, does Reece.
You can see Reece McLaren's trying to utilize that Muay Thai clinch and grab onto the head and possibly pull him down for a knee, but Wada's got a very tough clinch of his own.
Overhook on the right arm there from Reece McLaren. A chance for the knees from Wada, goes to the inside thigh. Reece looks for a takedown, couldn't affect it. Higher knee there from Wada, nicely done to the rib cage. Still overhooking that right arm, Reece McLaren in his corner. Vincent Perry giving the instructions.
Wada's got a very tight body lock as he now is trying to suck the leg away from McLaren. He gets McLaren down. Good job by Wada.
Something you don't see often. Wada, a takedown of Reece McLaren inside the guard of the Aussie. Close guard now from Reece. Halfway through the opening round. Higher guard now from the Australian. And Wada break it open, posture up and work the ground and pound. And Olivier Kost is going to give them some more space to move.
Now on the ground, Reece McLaren is a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt with a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu competition record of 170 wins and 22 losses. So highly experienced on the ground is McLaren.
McLaren looking for an arm here. Down from the right hand of Wada, catches him on the second one, sweetly to the chin. Foot on hips here from Reece McLaren, pulls the head down, controlling Wada's posture, locking him down inside the guard, closing him down, not allowing the ground and pound. Wada pops the head out. Foot on hips again from Reece to create some distance. 2 feet on hips now. Wada wants to get the hands free and do that, the ground and pound. Back inside the guard. 1 foot on hips from Reece, one butterfly hook, gives up on that now and forces him away.
Nice striking exchanges from Wada in this top position. Very, very tricky. He separates, creates a little bit of space, distracts his opponent by pulling the leg up, and then slips in with a big shot.
Feet on hips again from Reece McLaren, throws the legs up, this is dangerous. Hoping to lock up that arm, but Wada, a little too slick. Now the Muay Thai clinch from Wada, and McLaren breaks off. The Aussie up on the ball, we see the crowd here in Guangzhou, appreciating the martial arts skill set. McLaren, KG himself, takes the outside leg kick. Switching stance, McLaren, between southpaw and orthodox.
Wada's got a very relaxed striking style, hands down by his waist, kind of sticking his tongue out a little bit, mimicking what Reece McLaren was doing to Viviano.
McLaren shot in, Wada with a Muay Thai clinch. Can he execute the knees from here? Maybe even the elbows. McLaren backs him into the corner now. 15 seconds remains. First round, been a real seesawing to and fro battle between two highly skilled martial artists.
I'm kind of surprised at Wada here, you know, but he's got a very good grappling game, and he's winning some of these exchanges inside the clinch as Reece answers right back.
Both men throwing elbows to being close to a new ripper of the first round.
Tatsumitsu Wada looked impressive in the first round. It'll be interesting to see what kind of strategy Reece McLaren's team comes out with in the second round. Look at that trip, got the outside trip, was able to posture, control, and landed big shots like that one, that straight right hand coming from the standing position into guard. Cerebral is the perfect word to describe Tatsumitsu Wada.
The guard there from Reece McLaren. Beautiful raking elbow across the cheekbone from Wada. And there's one to the other cheek. Good view of both men in their corners, receiving plenty of instruction. McLaren saying that he would submit Wada. Wada saying he would KO McLaren. Second round set for three of our co-main event. Here at ONE Championship in Guangzhou, China. It's battle for the heavens.
Ready?
Round two.
Talk. What does Wada need to do here, Mitch?
I liked what he was doing in that first round. I want to see him get that clinch, close the distance, and drag McLaren to the ground and stay on top and deliver some ground and pound. I want to see McLaren keep this on his feet and get a little bit more respect shown from Wada. I want to see him hurt Wada on the feet.
McLaren edging forward. Southpaw stance on the Aussie. Throws the left cross down the center. Wada resets. Wild right hands down the tube from him, flailing on the inside. Couldn't land one cleanly. Now it's McLaren's turn to come forward.
With Wada with his arms up so high and elbows wide, that leaves it perfectly open to some body kicks from McLaren.
McLaren continually changing stances in orthodox now. Overhand right from Wada. McLaren goes for a double, gets a takedown. Nicely done from the Aussie. Top nice. Position for Reece McLaren, Mitch.
Nice shot from McLaren. He does that beautifully. His duck under double leg is a thing of beauty. Absolute poetry in motion. Now we can see what Wada's like off his back. We saw him be very controlling from the top position, but what's he going to be like on the bottom now?
Elbow to the collarbone there from Tatsumitsu Wada.
Watch out your head.
McLaren going to try and improve his position for a submission. Some ground and pound there from a fiery Reece McLaren. What do you think the corner of Wada are barking at him at the moment, Mitch?
Right now he's controlling the right arm, so you can see he's controlling the posture, and he can start dropping a little bit of that right hand to the side of the head right there, because you can still do damage from this position, especially in the short range elbows. Wada's got a very active guard. You can see him trying to trap that arm, possibly throwing up a triangle if he can clear his right leg.
Reece McLaren, the man they call Lightning. Can he do another Lightning submission here against Tatsumitsu Wada? Foot on hip here from Wada. Trying to keep McLaren at bay. McLaren working to better his position. Looks to go for the ground and pound. Back on top. Yes, he does. And now McLaren can go to work. He puts the figure four. He puts the body triangle. That'll make it hard for Wada to breathe. McLaren in control.
Especially in the side like this, you can see he's kind of off to the right side of Wada, so that pressure is going to be even more intense on that body triangle. But a lot of Japanese martial artists are very comfortable giving up their back because their rear naked choke defense is so good.
McLaren looking to reset that body triangle. 2 minutes, 5 remains. Second round of three. It's been a fantastic matchup so far. Tries to set the choke again. This Lightning Reece, has he got it this time? Can Reece McLaren top out Tatsumitsu Wada?
Wada's chin is tucked, so this is more of a face crank as the forearm is across the chin. It's very uncomfortable, but it's not a choke.
And Reece will have to reset it again. There's the rear naked choke defense that Mitch Chilson spoke about. Still plenty of time remaining, 1:35 in this round.
You can see Tatsumitsu Wada has got to control that hand right as Reece McLaren throws the arm, the leg over to go after the arm.
How dynamic are these submissions, one to another, from Lightning Reece McLaren. We're going to take on the arm, take it back to Christmas Island. Defending, though, is Wada.
He's trying to break that grip. If Wada can keep his hands tight, it's going to be impossible for McLaren to extend that arm. But you can see McLaren, he's close.
He's working for it. Can he break the grip of Wada? McLaren's trying to pull free fingertips. Fingertips only. Defending the knee, coming across there, the grappling expertise. Look at Wada. Shifts his position, but is he stuck here?
He's got the arms tri-
is fantastic. This is magnificent from both men. Still working for the sub here, Reece McLaren. Switches it up again, and he'll get back to his feet. What an exchange on the ground.
Very effective second round for Lightning Reece McLaren. Very good ground control from the Australian.
Big crowd here in Guangzhou, China, appreciating every moment of the martial arts skill on display. And McLaren driving double leg takedown.
Okay.
Final seconds of the second round. It's been an absolute cracker.
McLaren might have ate a knee as he shot in for that double leg, but a very good second round for Reece McLaren. The grappling was put on display in the second. Look at it. That double leg takedown was beautiful. Here he is telling the referee he might got hit in the back of the head as he lets a little bit of ground and pound go, but this was the most significant portion of the match so far. He's able to secure the body triangle, went after the choke, transitioned beautifully into a near armbar finish. That might have been a near finish, not quite sure if the judges are gonna score it that way, but a very good round on the ground for McLaren.
Mitch, you will not see higher level martial arts than we are seeing here between Reece McLaren and Tatsumitsu Wada. This really is a treat to watch.
That it is, especially if you appreciate the ground game. And all the viewers at home, no matter where they are in the Super App, are learning how to appreciate the ground game.
Third and final round. It's come down to these 5 minutes. And the crowd here in Guangzhou, China, on the edge of their seats.
Highly
appreciative, highly knowledgeable martial arts crowd here in Guangzhou tonight. Southpaw stance again from Reece McLaren. Fires out the cross off the left. Wada's got to be careful not to leave himself exposed when he fakes. Goes to the body himself. Fake there from McLaren. Roundhouse kick to the legs from Wada. Again, chin high in the air as Wada comes forward. McLaren trying to make him pay.
Interesting entry into the clinch. Wada was trying to grab the wrist of McLaren. Used that to bring him in. Was trying to punch off the same thing, but uses the clinch to drag McLaren back to the ground.
McLaren closes up the guard, and Olivia Kosh is going to move them away from the ropes. Okay, from this position, Mitch, what does Reece McLaren do with Wada inside his closed guard?
There's lots of McLaren's gonna do. Look at him, he's trying to pin down the arm, immediately gets his feet up to the hips, and he's looking to throw up a possible submission again. He likes the arm bar, he likes the triangle from this position, but Wada's got a very heavy top game from here. Look for Wada to try to smother him and really just cut a hold on for the last 3.5 minutes here, but he's got to do more than that because of the significant groundwork and time that McLaren was able to be in a dominant position.
McLaren still working his guard game here. Wada wants to posture up and work some ground and pound. We saw some very heavy ground and pound earlier on in this contest from Wada, particularly when it's the elbows drop. No chance to do so at the moment. They're sliding back towards those ropes. Looks to pass guard, goes to half guard now to Tatsumitsu Wada.
McLaren's doing a good job of avoiding damage for a top guy, a guy on top, to show ground control. He has to be A, throwing ground and pound, and B, he has to be advancing his position. You have to see him try to work up the body, pass guard, get past the half guard, ultimately in the side control or mount.
There's an elbow from Wada, smack bang across the kisser, and McLaren does a quick count of his teeth. Wada looks to posture up and work more ground and pound from his half guard position.
But it doesn't really score heavily just to lie on top of your opponent in the global rules set, scoring to just lie there and not do anything. Just because you're on top, lying on top of your opponent does not mean you're controlling the match.
All right, guys, Brett.
And now Olivier Coast agrees with Mitch Chilson. Not enough action happening down there. He restands him. Halfway through the third round, a bull rush there from Wada. McLaren tries for a hook and an uppercut. Wada looks on the clinch. Can he throw the knees? No, he can't. They spin some punches. Wada gets underneath the hook. Reece turns him around, backs him against the ropes, drops levels now, the Aussie throws a knee. There's an elbow from Reece McLaren.
Wada is tenacious with this clinch. I'd like to see McLaren swim in, get a clinch of his own, and start throwing some knees.
How about that Muay Thai elbow? The crossing elbow from Wada.
Beautiful.
McLaren in tough position. 1:45 to go. This seesawing battle.
Beautiful inside trip from McLaren as he dropped down, changed levels, got the inside trip, and now he's in the guard of Wada.
Okay, talk it through again here, Mitch. What does McLaren do here?
Well, McLaren's going to try to pass on this one side, but right as I said that, Wada's able to secure the full guard position now with his closed legs. Now Reece McLaren might just try to ride out the last 80 seconds on top, throwing bombs.
Feet on hips here, throws the legs up to Wada. Nothing happening there, and Reece gets off a little more ground and pound. There's the left hand from the Australian. Elbow to the collarbone, thought about it, did Wada. What's McLaren looking to do here, Mitch?
McLaren, he's trying to posture, he's trying to step over just like that, pat into half guard. Now he's going to try to step over with the other leg too, but Wada's got a very active guard. Hard to pass, Reece McLaren's trying though.
Wada thought about snatching up an arm, it wasn't quite there for him. 45 seconds remains now. Still top position for Reece McLaren. Wada. Elbow to the top of the head, along that brand new haircut of Reece McLaren. McLaren looking to pass again. 30 seconds remains now. Wada may have been trying to find a way back to his feet. Anything can still happen here. McLaren takes the back of Wada. Can he find him out? Can he find a choke in the final stages?
Oh, that was beautiful. He was consistently changing the angle at which he was trying to step over. And then he finally found the right move, slid over, almost took the back. Wada gave up mount in the process. And McLaren chases an arm bar.
What an exclamation mark for Reece McLaren to put on this contest dragon.
Wow, McLaren showed a very effective ground game. Showing that PJJ black belt was well deserved. Wada put up a very valiant effort in his own right, continually to push the action, really controlled the clinch pretty well, consistently very aggressive, very entertaining ground battle between two highly educated flyweights.
We said earlier on it could be the showstopper, it could be the show stealer in front of this magnificent crowd inside the Guangzhou Tiana Gymnasium Stadium in China. And indeed, Reece McLaren versus Tatsumitsu Wada, a contender for the match of the night. This is going to be interesting. Let's go right to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one scores this bout in favor of the blue corner. Judge number two scores this bout in favor of the red corner. And judge number three scores this bout in favor of your winner by split decision from the blue corner, Reece McLaren.
Go! Let's see what Toivonen is made of on the biggest martial arts stage in the world.
Right. Toivonen looks really relaxed, not fazed by these big lights here in the championship.
Right hand lead there from Fujisawa. Jab from Toivonen. Fujisawa, right hand lead, hooks up the lead hand.
He's really committing to those punches. He's definitely closing that distance, trying to get it nice and tight. I expect Toivonen to shoot a double leg off one of these punches from Fujisawa.
That took there from Fujisawa.
Fujisawa's doing a good job of, as soon as he punches, he immediately tries to sidestep to the left or right, trying to avoid that double leg.
Fujisawa comes in off the loss to Ramon Gonzalez last time out back in April by first round rear naked choke. before that was on a five-match winning streak, including a win over Rocky Bakhtal, over Kaji Eben, Sandeep Gurung, Jurawat Unjai, and Chan Samat.
And landed on the top of the forehead there from Toivonen.
Opponent also comes in for loss last time to Aaron Okbayan back in September of 2018. He too was on a great streak before that, including six wins and one no contest.
Yeah, Michael, that loss by Toivonen is actually what triggered him to go to evolve mixed martial arts and level up his training out there. Good movement from Fujisawa. I like the angles that he's coming with. Good head movement, utilizing that lateral movement and throwing the hands.
In eight contests, Toivonen has never been into the third round. He's only been into the second round once. That was on his pro debut. And since then, every contest has ended in the first round. What will happen if Fujisawa can draw the Finn to deep water?
Angled punches there coming from Fujisawa. He's definitely sticking to the game plan here, the lateral movement, not standing in front of Toivonen.
Toivonen, the submission specialist, five sub wins, including two arm bars, two rear naked chokes, just the one knockout victory. It was a TKO of Salim Bektaniev back in April of last year. Took him just towards the end of the first round to score that TKO.
Toivonen's got to be careful not to leave his head up when he's moving backwards. That's when Fujisawa's starting to connect. And Fujisawa starts to push forward, and he's throwing combinations. The way that Toivonen's backing up with his chin up in the air, he's got to be careful with that.
Jab from Toivonen, had his quickest win ever back in 2015, a 32-second rear naked choke submission of Harimata. Outside lucky from Toivonen, low single here from Fujisawa. Toivonen climbs onto the back, and that could spell disaster for Fujisawa. Is this the beginning of the end for Akihiro Fujisawa? Yes, it is. Welcome to ONE Championship, the giant, Aleksi Toivonen. He taps out Akihiro Fujisawa, and yet another first round finish.
Wow, didn't even need to shoot the double. Hurt him with the leg click kick. You can see he went after the lower leg. Fujisawa dropped. Watch that. Look at that beautiful leg kick right there. Hurt him, came down. Fujisawa goes after the leg. Look at how he traps the arm here with his leg as he steps over. That arm is trapped right there. The hook goes in on the other side, rolls him over to his back, sneaks that left arm under the chin, wraps up the rear naked choke, and the tap is academic. Beautiful debut from Toivonen. Welcome to ONE Championship.
Impressive indeed from the giant Toivonen. Here's Dom Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yoshinori Umeki, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 27 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of rear naked choke, Aleksi Toivonen.
Huge step up here for Gurdarshan Mangat. Can he do it? Or has Mangat bitten off more than he can chew? Reece McLaren going down the center corridor with the hand. Southpaw stance on Mangat. Orthodox on Reece. Looks for a two and single takedown attempt at the Australian. Mangat comes around. Tries to stay vertical. Still on his feet here, Gurdarshan Mangat. Reece tries for a double leg now.
Mangat expected this. He knew Reece was going to shoot early and often. Takedown from Reece McLaren. Immediately tries to jump into full mount. Mangat has that left hand on that right leg, preventing him from getting the full mount. Expect Reece to start transitioning, start looking to pass this half guard.
The aggressive meter is running high for Australia's Reece McLaren in the early get-go.
Don't grab the
fence. Inside of half guard. McLaren, can he break it open? Posture up, work some ground and pound. Trying to pry that right leg out so he can pass and go to side control perhaps. But Mangat doing a great job of controlling the Aussie's posture.
He's got to get off his, he can't stay flat on his back. He's got to continually try to move. He told me that he does not want to stay in the guard position. He needs to scramble. He needs to get that movement. But you can see that pressure from Reece McLaren, how he's driving his shoulder right into the chin of Mangat and forcing his head to turn away. So Mangat's not able to turn onto his side and start to escape. Good techniques so far shown by Reece McLaren, the BJJ black belt.
On the one fantasy gun, on the one super rap, an overwhelming amount of fans, 73% tipping a win for Reece McLaren tonight.
Yeah, not just on the fantasy app, but on YouTube as well. These guys, Reece McLaren has overwhelming support right now on the chat on YouTube. So let's see if Reece McLaren can get past his half guard.
Good position.
Been in this position for a while. But McLaren knows all the tricks on the ground. There's a reason they call him Lightning. He is so fast, both on the feet, but especially on the ground. 7 submissions in 12 wins, 58% of victories by sub for Reece McLaren, 2 knockouts. Also, a 170 win record in BJJ competition.
Oh, this is classic BJJ right here. Look how he's driving that shoulder into the chin, forcing Gurdarshan Mangat's head to the left. So what he's not able to do is he can't scoot onto his right and start to move out. This is high-level BJJ. These are the subtleties that you got to pay attention to. And right now, Gurdarshan Mangat was almost able to get away, but Reece McLaren with that vice-like grip was able to maintain the grip, and now he's inside control. It's a bad spot for Mangat.
From top position, side control for the Aussie, working his way to try and sniff out a submission on Gurdarshan Mangat. 140 remains, first round of 3.
McLaren was looking for north-south, but Mangat was able to defend correctly. Now he's still in side control, staying so tight. Look at how tight he is. Has the knee on the hip, right there on that right side of Gurdarshan Mangat. Not able to go anywhere. Then he's got the hand over the head of Gurdarshan Mangat. So he's got that cross point control. And Mangat's not able to go anywhere.
Hello to all of our Indian fans watching on Star Sports Select 2 and Hotstar in India. No doubt cheering on their man, Gurdarshan Mangat. North-south position here. Mangat looks for an opening to try and take a win home. Try and take the victory back to Australia. Reverse elbow, full mount. Here mounts Mangat. How do you do? Here's the ground and pound. Here's the ground and pound, the elbow. The right hand. Reece McLaren aggressive in the opening round.
That was a technical display of brilliant zillion jiu-jitsu proficiency. That was academic, from the side control to the mount to the way that he was able to control all the positions. Once he got that hand around the neck, he was able to sink it in tight. Here comes the, what's he gonna do? He's gonna pose. We'll give him his moment.
What a way to end the year for Lightning Reece McLaren. The Australian taps out the Indian. Must be something about 2019. The Aussies had it over the Indians in cricket. Tonight, it's in mixed martial arts.
Look at this. Stepped over into mount. You can see Gurdarshan Mangat tries to create the scramble. Almost got back into half guard, but then he just went to it one too many times. He tried that sit-up escape. Reece McLaren saw it coming the second time and gets that rear naked choke in ever so deep and was forced. That tap, beautifully done by Gert, by Reece McLaren.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 35 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of rear naked choke, Reece McLaren!